Welcome you all to today's modular classroom. Today we are going to see about the virtual labs. Nowadays we have started our online teaching due to this pandemic situation, and now we are handling our theoretical papers easily with some demonstration, presentation and so on. But how can we handle the virtual labs? Especially today we are going to see about how we can handle the virtual labs for computer science faculty members. So come on, let's explore this. So, Virtual Lab is an initiative of MHRD under the mission of aegis of National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology. So, it is a consortium activity of 12 participating institutes, and IIT Delhi is coordinating this institute. It is a paradigm shift in the ICT-based education, and for the first time, this initiative has been taken up in remote experimentation. Under Virtual Labs project, over 100 virtual labs consisting of approximately 700 plus web-enabled experiments were designed. So who are all the beneficiaries? So all the students and faculty members of science and engineering colleges who do not have access to good lab facilities or instruments, high school students, researchers in different institutes, different science and engineering colleges, virtual labs do not require any additional infrastructural setup for conducting experiments at user premises. We don't want to set up any extra additional softwares or nothing. Directly, we can go on to this virtual labs and directly we can demonstrate our experiments. The simulation-based experiments can be accessed remotely. Come on, let's see how it is possible. Now, we can enter into Google, or directly we can enter into vlab.co.in. This is the virtual labs, which is an initiative of MHRD. So from here at the bottom, you can find the broad levels of virtual labs, which is available for all engineering majors: electronics, communication, computer science, electrical, mechanical, chemical, biotechnology, civil, physical, and chemical sciences. Now we are going to see on computer science and engineering. Once we click on what are all the labs which are ready for use is being available. At the right side, you can find each lab is given by, it is already we have said it is a collaboration of so many institutes under Delhi IIT. So basics of HTML is given by IIT Delhi, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Hyderabad, and so on. So for example, if you want to use any particular subject, especially if I want to teach on HTML lab or web programming lab, you can click on that particular thing. You can find some introduction, objectives, what are all the list of experiments in available. 10 experiments are available, and we can go for an easy demonstration of all these experiments. And then if I want to explain on some HTML introduction, I can click on that. You can have a demonstration here. There is also some pre-test procedures are available. The 5-step procedure is being given. Then you can go for simulation. The simulation is where you can easily go in for a demonstration. Here you can see all the tabs. So handling web programming or HTML programming will be very easily understand what are all these tags. So H1 to H6, the heading differences has been available. See, if I click on H1, H2, you can see the size getting increased in this text. So this is what it is. And P for paragraph, B for bold. Once I click I, you can find at the right side, this it gets in italics, U underline, B for big, S for small, response changes to small. Even you can show here, and you can in here at the bottom, you can have a code section and the preview section. If I give on HTML, you can find the end tag gets generated automatically. Within that, if I give body, you can find the body. Here, whatever we give in body, it gets displayed at the right side at the preview section, you can see. Before the welcome, if I give H1, you can see it is in H1 tag. So it is big. So similarly, if you give this in H6, it will be small. So this is where you can explain the differences between the H1 tag and the H6 tags, and all the levels which comes under H1 to H6. Now we can see the difference. This is H1 and this is H6 at the right side. So easily we can show the preview. You need not type the coding. You need not type the script of HTML scripting. You need not go for running. You need not have an open the browser and show the students. This HTML, lot of experiments are available. And if you click on bold, all tags can be experimented here. You will be getting a bold interface. So whatever we type within bold, it gets bold. Whatever we type within I, it gets italics. So easily, if you click on the cursor, the output difference can be viewed. Even you can show how the code can be written and how the output can be viewed. So it is a very wonderful outcome from this MHRD, and we faculty members can use it easily and project to the students how these lab experiments can be worked out. And when we look into some other subjects, here also we can, if in the experiments itself, you can find some differences in other experiments. If you take on tables, you will be having some table experiments also, list of experiments. If you want to explain some list or even table, you can generate with the number of rows and columns, creating tables, mark you tags, everything, anchor tags, mark you which moves from left to right or right to left, everything can be shown. Anchor tags, you can insert images using image tags, everything. Again, if you see how you can create tables, here you should enter into simulation, and here you can show how many rows you want, how many columns, where you want to align the table, right to left, what is the background color, you can select any color, what the color you want for border, how much width you want, so 300 for 300 pixels if I'm giving, and if I submit, you can see at the right side 2x2 table is being generated with the given specified color. But what is the coding actually, how it should be? You have the table tag, TR tag for table rows, TD tag for table data, etc. So this tag coding can be copied into the code section, and the output will be previewed in the preview results section. So wonderfully, we can go out for this laboratory experiments. Similarly, you can go for some image processing, computer graphics. All the labs which is available can be utilized based on the syllabus and the contents which we need. So you can go for, now I'm taking some example of image processing. You can easily demonstrate the list of experiments. You can go for color image processing. You can go to the experiment, click on the experiment here. You should select an image. So an image is selected. You can select any color space which we want. If you give a HSI, it's okay. Hue, saturation and intensity for HSI. And you can click on run. So the immediately, its corresponding hue, saturation and intensity are generated. If you're handling only the theory paper, you need not have to install for MATLAB or any image processing software. You can directly go to this VLAB and show the demonstration how this HSI will be implemented. So all the features are available, and it is the way how we are using this technologies and the resources available. And really, it is a wonderful initiative of MHRD, and hope it will be very useful for all the teaching faculties of computer science. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.